Hello, my celestial beings. This is Mystic Storm here to clear the path to a new life with you. I hope you're having a wonderful day, evening, whenever you catch this. And I just feel like I need to say, I'm back. Even though I've posted last month, I've been itching to get back. But I had to get myself together. I had to get my energy right. And that's what we need to do. We need to have boundaries with ourselves. We need to take time to collect. And I know we're just getting out of Virgo season, so that makes a lot of sense, right? And I want to talk about the Aries full moon that's coming up on October 9th. We're in the year 2022. I have the need to say that because, again, these messages, whenever they hit you, they are timeless, okay? Time is an illusion. Let's get that true. Time is an illusion, all right? So, I got my chart over here. I have some cards over there. And we're going to get it popping, okay? I want to title this Death to the Old Self because I feel like this is the ultimate time to shed. Especially for the Aries full moon. The Aries energy is all about the I am, okay? It's all about the I am. And with that being said, we can go into a little bit of reflection right now because think about Aries season during spring. And now that we're in fall, reaping the harvest of what we have sown this year, right? It is time for us to now make room for the new creations we are trying to work on manifesting for the upcoming year, okay? So I just want to reiterate, Aries is all about the self, its appearances, new beginnings, right? It's our body. Focuses on the body, okay? We always talk about mind, body, spirit, but I know me, out of all the ones, I probably mostly neglect the body. Like, I'm pretty much like, I am with spirit. Like, I'm probably so close that I have no care in the world to leave this beautiful vessel. But at the same time, we're here for a reason. So it's not a death to yourself as far as you're going to leave this earth. It's a death of the recycling. This is the rebirth. This is eternal life. This is eternal life. It's the constant cycles of death and rebirth. Death and rebirth. We are approaching Scorpio season, so that makes total sense. And it's funny because I was talking to a few people last week, and I told them about my theory of people who commit suicide, trigger warning, or unalive themselves. We get that itch, that it's the depressive states, the ebbs and flows of life, to the point when we are approaching a rebirth, right? We might get visions or sounds of us saying that we need to go ahead and unalive ourselves. But in actuality, those are just symbolisms of that you're going through a death. You're going through a metamorphosis, right? A transition, a new beginning. Because after death comes life, comes new beginnings. After ending comes a new beginning. So instead of completely leaving this earth completely, why not die here in the now? And step into the newness of you, Phoenix rising, okay? I hope that's making sense right now, tapping into the Aries full moon, okay? This is a prime time to release. We might feel uncertain about who we really are or what we are transforming into. It's a sense of becoming. Who are you becoming? And how can you align to keep that if you want to stay on that path? Sometimes we get veered off and we need to recalibrate. Other times there's sudden changes that we have to recalibrate in order to get on a different trajectory that doesn't necessarily have to be all bad, okay? So, death to the old self. Like, how do you want to show up? And it's like, don't constantly compare yourself in the past, because that's gone, that's done. All you have here is the now, right? And the vision of the future. And whatever vision that you see yourself in, attune to that, recalibrate to that, so that way you can be that future self now. I'm hearing ringing. So I must be on to something. This is a true Age of Aquarius energy. And I do want to say shout out to, I'll claim her as my mentor, Tyra Omolade. I know y'all have heard me shout her out in the past, but I mean, she keeps me every week. Bless her soul. Lord bless her family, all of that, because she show up every week and help sisters. We got sisters or like jihad, and we may be feeling down and out, but it's the feeling of community, right? Which is really good. Look, I'm over here. Yeah, make sure you check out her channel. I love Tyra. Yes. But I don't even know where I was going after saying that. I guess because she kind of got into that Age of Aquarius and the meditation. She does wonderful meditations, hypnosis tracks. So, like, yeah. I love her. But that's what it reminds me of with the meditations that she has us do. Is thinking about who you want to be and aligning to that, pretty much. And whatever happened in the past, yes, we can reflect. And whatever doesn't serve us, just shed it. Shed the narrative. Rewrite it. You know? A lot of times we let our traumas steer and affect us to the point where it controls our future. It controls our now. And we're in a prison in our own mind. This is where we need to get grounded and secure within ourselves to know who we are and who we are becoming, and stand firm in that. Let no one shake that. Even if it feels rocky sometimes, having that faith, resting in the divine, letting the divine take control sometimes, and just trust. Follow your intuition, following the guidance. You'll get the signs. If you're aware, you will see. You will see. Your eyes will be clear. Yeah. I'm hearing you already know who you are. You have to embrace it. You are the only one that is holding you back. Don't be consumed by what other people are doing and saying. Your vision, your guidance, it's your power. Let the divine mount over your head and take over. You will see that it has all been here from right along. groundedness is purity, because it's primal. And in that groundedness, you are your rawest, truest form. And in that rawness, you will see that no one can touch you. So why do we fear? Why do we fear? We are afraid of ourselves. We are afraid of winning. Why not just let go and just simply win? Simply do, simply be, without a care. You are doing good already. No one has to tell you why you should do something. If it is in your heart, do it. If it's in your heart, if it's in your mind, in your vision, see it through. Take action, but not with force, with ease, because you are flowing with the universe. You are in constant balance. It's a season for everything. That's why we have the elements. We have four elements, or you want to say five because that's spirit. But then we also have the four seasons, right? We are in fall. It's time to shed. It's time to get into that darkness, baby. The underworld, shadow work. Internal healing. We are changing every day on a cellular level. It's in the choices we make. So make sure that you are doing what you can to have longevity for your future. Okay, that was a lot of downloads right then and there. I have the chart pulled up, but I don't even know, like, if I'm really going to need it today. I might look at some things as we pull, but that was pretty much probably all I had to say. that on that. So we're going to tap in. We're going to start in with the Wild Unknown archetypes. I've wanted this deck for a long time, but then I've been scared of it in a sense where it's like, oh, I have to learn this and I don't want to read the stuff on camera and blase, blase. But again, I'm putting this first for a reason, because I want to believe in myself, and that's it. We're changing, and I think that's scary. That's scary for a lot of us. Yeah, it's scary for a lot of us. We just have to have the strength and the courage to see it through. See, spirit. Divine source, what message, what guidance? Yes, the thread, I love it. The warrior, yeah, that's it. So, the thread and the warrior, I love this. You can see off the bat, we got the chakras raining in, we got the rainbow here, right? Where that thread is lining up to that beginning. We talked about being in the shadow and in the midst of the darkness, seeing that vision and piercing through it to get to the other side. to get to the other side. Trusting. Oh, trusting that you will get out of this, right? Trusting that the inner work that you're doing will not be in vain. It may seem like we constantly have to work on ourselves and there's always healing to do. We're always healing. But man, when I tell you, things get easier, things get better with time. It's just a lot of trial and error. But once you're secure within self, it's a steady climb. Then we have warrior. I love this. How we talked about primal. We got the snake with the kundalini, right? This is also kind of giving me a little bit of Baphomet. A little bit. And that's talking about, you know, the shadow, right? This is really good. But I'm also thinking about the crystal in here, right here with the eye, the vision. Crystal clear. Getting to the root, the bones, right? The skeleton in the closets, right? Yeah. It's gonna be hard. It's gonna be difficult. Yeah. I'm smiling like, yeah, it is. Because, man, we all go through the dark night of the soul type thing. And when we go through transitions and endings and new beginnings, this is the death to the old self. The old self wasn't working. The old self wasn't even the real self. Let's go there. You probably more than likely was operating out of fear or trauma or your environment that you were conditioned into. But now that you're learning to really getting to know yourself, how a lot of that you have to unlearn. A lot of it. And it's okay. It is okay. And it's funny. Of course, working with the root chakra is will help with everything, right? But aligning the root and the crown, I feel like we focus on the two, the ending and the beginning, right? The beginning is the root, the ending is the crown. So if we calibrate to doing that, everything else will flow. It's like maybe even mixing the energies, and then that way it can mix within the other chakras, and that's how we can get aligned. I feel like if we work on mixing and blend, not necessarily mixing, blending. This reminds me of the horizon over here. See how this is all separate? We're focusing just on one thing. We're only seeing this part of the story. We're separating and fragmenting our lives. Blend. And let it be a beautiful, harmonious sight to see. You. A lot of times we have to code switch. A lot of times we have to operate a certain way in different environments. You don't take me as me. Okay? This is the God. Okay? The God. Okay? This is the Norman. Take me as me. Come on, look at him adjusting. Yes, how can I help you? Yeah, this is me. Real sub moves. Like, yeah, so Let's look at Leo. What's in Leo? Actually, part of fortune is leaving. I still got some degrees left in Leo, but it's in the sixth house. Sixth house is all about health, fitness, systems, organizations, work habits, sense of usefulness, which is really good for your sense of self, right? Like, this is, that aligns with the self too, right? So having more confidence to really care for yourself, the more that you care for yourself, the more that you will show up in your authentic form, okay? Yeah. I heard no more. But at the base, I stopped. The Ankh, eternal life. Yeah. Okay. All right. I'm going to get into the tarot. And I feel like I have all these cards here, but I don't even know if I'm going to use them as much. But we're going to see. I hope you all gain some guidance with this. The messages. I will say, if you're doing rituals, of course, take a spiritual bath. The colors I would focus on, it's definitely like red, like the more primal colors. But you might even get, to be honest, a multicolor candle. And working on blending all aspects of the self, because it's not just this part of me. I am everything. I am all in one. Okay? And when I operate as my full self and my full power, I will treat myself as such. And therefore, I would not neglect my body. Therefore, I will take care of myself. Therefore, I will set better boundaries. Therefore, I will speak my truth. Okay? Blending the energy, blending the chakras. Okay? It's like we focus on different aspects. And it's, yeah, we're supposed to get maybe focused. But it's time to step back and look at the bigger picture. And see that there's beauty in that. Okay? Oh, it's cool. Thank you, Spirit. Thank you. Truth hurts. Tell me the truth now. What have you been doing and who have you been doing it with? Truth hurts. No longer are we in fear. Okay, with this Nine of Swords in reverse. Who do we need to fear? Why? For what? Why? You know what we're afraid of? Because we know. We know what's inside of us. The warrior. The warrior god. The warrior goddess. Right? The warrior goddess. All right? So, it's no need. Continue to climb out of that dark space. Continue to do it. Because it's not your home. You were there to get more clarity on who you really are. You're not afraid anymore to go down this path to enter the unknown. or you're not afraid to take the long way, to take the scenic route, to enjoy the view, the journey. It's all about the journey, not the destination. We get so caught up in the destination. We get stubborn, hard-headed, releasing them. It's beautiful. Truth hurts, man. We'll go with the Five of Swords. And maybe truth hurts, but also false truths, right, hurt. I feel like this could be us speaking our minds and our boundaries, or this is killing all the self-criticism, right? All the self-criticism that we've put on ourselves. This is to change that. The truth hurts is the only reason that we were in this energy is our own doing. It's the darkness here. It's the over-analytical believing that we can't do it. That we aren't good enough, that we don't have, and that dampens our vitality. Our energy levels are depleted because of that. Mm-hmm. I'm looking at the chart. I mean, the only thing I can probably think about is just Chiron and Aries. I really just want to Chiron and Aries. I know it's about self. We can talk about relationships too. This is definitely transforming relationships with us being in Libra season. Libra is in the eighth house. That scorpionic energy, that's the death, rebirth, eternal life. Death to the old self. And when we do that, we might have to sever some connections. This is all out of love. This is all out of love because Venus is conjunct with the sun. And it's funny because Tyra was telling us that Venus is going to be invisible because she's so close to the sun. And with that, we have to do some internal work on our beauty. It's like second house energy. It's like Taurus type energy. It's like, you know, our money, our sense of self-worth, and all these things. If we don't feel like we can do it, we're going to constantly put these thought forms in our mind. We're gonna speak down on ourselves to where we'll never do that. We're figuring out that we're our own worst enemy and our worst critic. I just seen 2828 on the timer here, right here. And number 28 is the God. We don't have to be, we are gods, goddesses, right? But we chose to be here to learn experiences, to evolve, to do all these things. So we don't have to be perfect. That's what it is. We want things to be perfect. But again, that's part of the process. That's part of the process. And we're going to start new beginnings. Passionate, fiery, bold, creative, sensual. This is Venus energy. We're starting from scratch. We're starting. We are starting from scratch. We're going to have to build. We're shedding. We're shedding because even here, the leaves have fallen. Right, fall. We're starting over because it wasn't good. It wasn't where we needed to be. We're rerouting, recalibrating. I love that. Yes. Getting change, maybe changing our morals, our disrupting traditions, making our own traditions. That might be something that we need to look into. Yeah. And also, yeah, it's funny that I picked it up and it stopped here with the devil. Primal, the warrior, playfulness, right? But this is also, it can be obsessive energy. Okay, then I put the base with the lovers. These might be unhealthy attachments here. Unhealthy attachments, how we have to love, or how we view ourselves. Because hold on, this could be relationships, but the lovers could be union with the masculine and the feminine parts of ourselves, because we are both masculine and feminine. Okay, so we got the God here, but I kept saying God and Goddess. Right? So I feel like that's what needs to be healed, is the God in us, the masculine part in us, how we step out and shine, our identity, how people see us. This is also giving me like 10th house energy, like Capricorn. That's why Capricorn, let me some Capricorns. And we got, okay, the 10th house has Sagittarius, but there's no planets in there. And the MC is there at the time of this full moon. So it's just like, yeah. We have to have that fire inside of us to keep going. That optimism, right? That inner wisdom that will connect to us in a more healthier way, or embracing both aspects of ourselves, right? The higher self and the lower self, right? This what needs to be worked on, the lower self, because if we if we really knew ourselves, our shadow selves, right? If we have to let go of those constructs, because if we really knew, we would actually have more fun, right? We get through all this darkness, we would actually enjoy it. And know that we don't have to be confined by it. Yeah. Death to the old self, putting limiting beliefs and chains and limitations, because Saturn rules Capricorn. So this can be restrictions. But again, these are restrictions not by spirit, it's us. We're putting those restrictions on us, on ourselves. There said we can have it all. We can have it all. We can put ourselves in different situations and isolate, because it's like a test. It's like a game or an experimentation. Because sometimes we need to limit or restrict some things, set boundaries to some things to make it how we want it, right? But at the same time, forcing a habit can get us to where we get locked up and not want to progress all the time. Know that there's more out there. Love doesn't bind, it's free. So maybe you're binding yourself, you're limiting yourself. You might also, and if you're doing that, you're also doing that in your other relationships. Alright, we talking about love and stuff. I'm gonna do the Lover's Oracle and we'll see where we go from there. We'll probably close out after that. But we are in Libra season. Okay, the Lovers is here too. Yeah, it's all about partnerships, commitments, right? So also, this can help, like, yeah, you might feel like you're stuck in a situation, and that's not necessarily the case. That is not, especially a situation where it restricts you, it confines you. You don't feel like you can be who you really are. You're operating more low vibrational because they see the God in you and they want to maybe crush it. Alright, this is time for you to keep. Yeah, they pulled you in this dark space. It's time to climb up out of it and then cut the cord. Cut the cord. Yeah. Yeah. Soulmate, so beautiful. It says your soulmate is already with you in spirit. Believe this and they will manifest physically. So again, these restrictions that we're putting on ourselves, probably not cutting it. Release these concepts of you. Maybe if you're speaking death to yourself, then who else, you know, if you feel that way about yourself, how can you expect somebody else to see this if you're not operating in it? It's like, yeah, love is coming if it's not already here for you, okay? Your soulmate is already here with you in spirit, all right? Enjoy the ride, enjoy the journey. And does that mean you probably have to date around some? Yeah. I know it. But you gotta do what you gotta do. Gotta do what you got to do. I'm gonna read this one too. Yeah. It says, the past is now behind you. Release and embrace new opportunities. A new path is now available to you. Follow it with faith. Three of Wands. Yeah. Yeah. Enjoy the ride. This is like us getting out of toxic situations. And the toxicity of maybe toxic relationships. And also realizing that we ourselves can also be toxic to ourselves, like our vices, things that have control over us, how we escape. Yeah, this is continuing to shed old skin and aiming for more high vibrational way of life. Healing. Imagine yourself and your beloved surrounded by light. Feel your relationship being healed this very moment. So if you're going through a tough time with a partner, or it can be any partnership. It can be relationships. It could be business partnerships. Just imagine that or visualize that relationship being healed or the conflict being resolved by putting a white light around you all. Okay? And I'm also kind of getting like the figure eight action, how we talked about blending. It's the magician. It's the magician. It's energy work. It's flowing. Okay? Yeah. All right. We're going to get into the last card. It's the Wild Offering. I hope you all enjoyed. I hope this message kind of made sense. I feel like I was all over the place, but I feel like it flowed in the same at the same time. So let me know. All right, Spirit, what is the final message? Come on. Being enough. Being enough. Being enough. It says, the innermost heart says, you are enough. Nowhere to go, nothing to get, nothing to change. No need to grow more deserving. You, yes, you are love. Let go. Let go. You simply are. When we are becoming, it's because we are already it. And we have to be reminded of that. That we are enough. Letting go of the constraints that we've put on ourselves, what society, what tradition has put on us. It's not our story. Erase it. Erase it. Blend all aspects of life. For life is eternal. Here on earth, life is eternal on earth, okay? We don't need to leave until it's our time to leave, okay? We don't have to do that. There's gonna be times where life is hard, but it's because we're going through cycles of constant death and rebirth. Death and rebirth. Continue to rise. Continue to rise. Loving yourself. Learning all aspects of yourself. And once you learn them, you compartmentalize, right? You compartmentalize each section, right? We understand subcategories. Make it one. Make it one. Yeah. We are who we are at our core, and nothing can change that. Get to the root and you will find your way. Ashe. So it is. Okay, I'm sending you all loving, healing energy, and I pray that we all see the beauty in ourselves, that we all see the power that we hold, that we all know that we can conquer, that we can endure, that we will succeed by simply being and becoming. Okay? I love you all. I hope y'all have a wonderful, wonderful day, and I will catch you in the next one.